Today we're gonna talk about apples a little bit. You can see I've got two different kinds of apples here. I don't have a Red Delicious because that's not typically one we're probably gonna be cooking with. So this one is more of like one of your cooking apples. So oftentimes when I say in there, you know, any variety, but get a cooking apple, it's gonna be one that's gonna sort of look like this. Maybe bigger, but you know, that's that standard cooking apple. And then we've also got our green or Granny Smith kind of apples. These most often we'll actually keep them raw if we're gonna use them, but sometimes we might cook them up. So I'm gonna show you a little bit of some tricks with both of these. So it's an apple, the first thing. It's pretty simple. We're just gonna take it in half. And then I like to go ahead and quarter it before I then tackle trying to get rid of the seeds and everything. And I usually switch to a smaller knife just for control. And then I make kind of a wedge shape, catching all of that stuff in the middle. And as I'm doing this, I'm taking a little bit of the bottom and the top with it to account for the kind of bottom of the apple and the top where the stem is. So as I'm coming towards myself, I'm being especially careful. And there we go. So now I have all of those pieces in quarters. From there, I can do a wide variety of things with my apple. First thing I can do is I can cut it again into smaller pieces. And then from there, I can cut up pieces like that and try and get even. The biggest thing with pieces is however you do it, you usually want them to be evenly sized pieces, right? So then I could also do, you know, slightly smaller pieces from that original one. Oh, I've got from that original quarter, I should say. I've got smaller pieces there. And then the other way usually is gonna be to just slice it. And then the size of the slices you get just depends on how close together you make those knife cuts. And of course, you know, they're not gonna be perfect slices because it's a round fruit, so you're not gonna be able to get that. So, right, it's like it's thinner on this edge than it is on that edge. That's fine, not the end of the world. Like with the pieces though, you know, the biggest goal is to try and make these apple slices as even as possible. That one turned out pretty thin. So that's the gist of apples. You know, again, once you kind of cut it open and you do the basics and get that core out, you can go in any number of places from there. You can have small pieces, large pieces. I could take this quarter and just cut it in half and there's some large pieces, right? Or I could do that and then quarter it again and there's some sort of, you know, still big but not quite as big pieces. So as you can see, there's lots of different options. I could take these slices, go smaller still. I mean, seriously, the sky's the limit. And I could even slice these thin and make kind of almost little baby apple sticks. You know, it's whatever we need you to do, but that's the basics. So understanding how to get it from this state into those quartered states is really the most important part. And then from there, you can pretty much do anything with your knife. I wanted to just say real fast, you know, a lot of times I might have you, or I will have you probably prep your apple on prep day because it does cut down time. The biggest thing when you do that is your apple is probably gonna end up browning a little bit, and that's okay, it's not the end of the world, it's just not quite as pretty. Every so often, I'll actually have you hold off though and cut the apple on the day you need it because we do want it to be that more kind of vibrant color. If that's the case, you know, we'll try, I work it into the recipe so that you kind of do it while something else is going on so you don't waste that time. If you do cut it on prep day and you don't like that it browns that much, you can use lemon juice and coat the edges. I could like throw all these pieces in a bag with the juice from one lemon and kind of toss it around, and that lemon juice is gonna help stop that browning process. So I just wanted to take a minute and talk about that. All right, that's it.